Hi guys, how you doing? This is the Queen Battle from Battle First Aid Responder Services live here from the Massachusetts Department of Health Licensing Bureau in the beautiful 239 Bedford Street here live in Boston, Massachusetts. We still have a lot to do, okay? Because of this pandemic epidemic, COVID-19, that's why the other issues are related to offices are available. Offices like this in every city, in every vicinity are available to get the right credentials, to get the right credentials that are needed for the local servicing agencies and local community health advocates, medical professionals, people that are want to verify their credentials and want to get approved for medical services, opportunities, medical education opportunities, through whatever they come to every city, every state, every part of the country has what they call these bureaus, the Department of Health Services in the UK, as well as in Paris, London, Germany. They have these services out here in some departments like these for people to actually verify the credentials, whatever office, whatever city they are in. They want to try to get out there and help big cities as well as small cities deal with resources and epidemics like these right now. 239 Medford Street in Boston, Massachusetts, okay? This is one of the small offices of the major Department of Health. The major Department of Health is near Dorchester in Boston. So we have a lot of other issues over there. permits, no law enforcement management, no police, and no security detail at these events.
That right there is a major.
So, of course, even if the conference, even if the convention has their own private contracting security, but they are not licensed security workers, if they are not licensed security guards, if they are not licensed security guards, but they are private contracting security guards, but they are not licensed security guards, and they are wearing the same technical gear that a licensed security guard wears, okay? You gotta understand me, guys. Listen to me, guys. If they are wearing the same clothing and the same security uniform and the same technical gear as a security officer, but they are not licensed security officers, you need to let the local legal law enforcement know that that is a security issue in the city. That is a major, 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 major security issue in your city, okay? Deal with small events like the DNC, deal with large events like the RNC. They hire out private contractors, private security enforcers for these events, but of course, they are not licensed. They are not licensed private contractors. Okay? These people are not licensed security guards. They are not licensed. They are private contractors employed by private firms to provide private security services for these events. But if you are working with politicians, you need licensed law enforcement. Hello, love. You need licensed law enforcement, especially if you are dealing with people that are involved in a major, major presidential event. You need licensed law enforcers. Licensed and legal law enforcers that are licensed peace officers, that are licensed security detail, that are licensed. They are not private contractors. They are not security contractors. They are licensed. Okay? There's sexual abuse. There's rape on the street. There's anything. Anything can happen here or there or whatever, but you have to make sure that these people, especially if you go to an event and a politician is already known to be at this event, a major, major politician, a major, major nationwide national event, especially like a national convention, whether it's a Republican or a Democratic convention, and there is supposed to be even one politician at this event, a senator or a governor, and there is no licensed law enforcement with any name tags on their vests, any name tags on their uniforms, any name tags, no badges, no uniforms, no, and you notice the difference between a real police officer, a real security officer, versus a security contractor. There is a difference. There is a difference between a military officer, a military veteran versus a government contractor. You know the difference. Even in the military, you have government contractors and you have military, uniformed military police, okay? Because the United States government always hires out private security contractors to do the same job as the military, but they are not military. They have never served in the military, but they are private security contractors, service employed by the United States government, but they are not, have never served in the United States military. They are private contractors, licensed. They are licensed, okay, as well. But these contractors have never served in the United States military. They wear the same gear, they wear the same uniform, they may even be licensed gun owners, but they have never served in the United States military. The military does it all the time. They do it all the time. They do it all the time. They hire their own military officials to do the duties, as well as they hire private contractors. People get robbed. I saw a guy who got robbed on the street today. You know, people get robbed all the time. Okay? The public needs to know what is the issue of concern. This is a public street. Medford, this is a public street. There's no issue. There's no privacy around here. There's no privacy. It's a public street. It is a public street. Again, you have to know the difference, and especially if you are at an event, if you are a public individual, if you are public and you have concern about a nationwide event coming to your city, if it's a convention, if it's a protest, and you see at this protest that there are no police officials at these protests guarding. You have over 10,000 people doing a protest in your city, in your downtown area. Okay. You have 10,000 people doing a protest in your downtown area, and you do not see any local law enforcement, no police cars, no police detail, no licensed security officers at this protest, but you see people walking around in tactical black, tactical gear with guns in your neighborhood. In your downtown area, they're walking around in black tactical gear and black tactical uniforms. But there is no security present at these events. Call your local law enforcement, as well as call upper management, call the military, call the National Guard, call whoever it is, and you can get security immediately to that city, because they do it all the time. Even with mega, even with people, they're trying to get in and literally robbing cities of their precious resources, as cities are losing valuable money as well as government grants. And keep going, come on, man. People are using government grants and government resources and not being able to provide precious resources, like right here at the Department of Health, provide precious resources to get out there to them and their communities. Okay. Okay, I'm telling you guys one more time. Even for military servicemen, military here domestic as well as military overseas, there is a difference. They wear the same uniform, they have on the same tactical gear, but you can understand the difference between a military service member, a veteran or a prior service member, or anybody that has given their life, raised their right hand and said, I will honor and protect and serve the United States Constitution under all domestic and foreign enemies. There's a difference. There's a difference between uniform military versus government contractors. There is a difference between military veterans and those who are service. And then come on, thank you. There's a difference between military servicemen versus government contractors. Okay. Government contractors. There is a difference. There's a difference between a contractor and there's a difference between a military service member. You have to understand the difference, especially if you see that the behavior in these events, if you see a security detail at these events and their behavior is a little bit strange. Okay, their behavior is a little bit, their behavior at these events, you have security detail, but these security detail are not performing normal security activities at these big, big political events. Okay? They are security detail. They are security contractors. They are not licensed security officials. Okay? Especially if there is no local police officials or no local state or police officials at these events. You have to make sure also not just check the behavior of the crowd, but check the behavior of the security officials at these events. Understand, as well as military, understand the security. It happens all the time. People that put on the same uniform, they put on the same black tactical gear, they put on the same police uniform, the same police official. It looks so genuine. It looks so legit. It looks like they are a real cop. In fact, they could do the same duties as a cop. They could do the same duties as a cop. They could do the same duties as a state police, but they are not licensed, okay? They could do the same duties as a police officer. They could do the same duties as a peace officer, but they are not licensed police officers. They are not licensed peace officers, okay? Please understand the difference. They are contractors. So somebody will hire these people because the people have the same experience
on the street or professionally as a security officer or as a police officer, they have the same experience, but they are not licensed in the police field. Or the same thing, they may be police officers, but they may be let off duty or fired from duty. Therefore, private companies will hire police officers that have been fired from their duty, from the position, and hire these fired individuals for private contracting events. So that way they can still stay employed and still get their experience and their service. But again, if they have anything bad in their record, then that tarnishes for life. And the only way they can still be employed in that field is by private contracting. You see how that works? It can be a good thing and it can be a bad thing. And you still be able to get the experience you need to be able to perform your service, as well as get back on your feet and get right back in the field. Say, you know what, I'm sorry, I made a mistake, but here shows I have the experience. Please let me back on the job, okay? So there are other issues. Okay, I really want the public to understand this, because I've been going through this at the Black Lives Matter rallies in here in New York, as well as here in Boston and Chicago. Okay. You have to understand the difference between a local licensed police officer versus a contracted police, a contracted security officer. You have to understand the difference, especially when it comes to these rallies. Hey, how you doing? Okay, so you have to understand the difference. That is low. That is really low. Can you take me on a date? Please understand the difference. Please understand the difference. There are supposed to be licensed, uniformed police officers. How do you know the difference between a licensed, uniformed police officer? A licensed, uniformed police officer will have their a name, they will have a badge. They will have a police badge with their name and their number ID on it. I'm here in front of the Department of Health to talk about this. They will have a badge with their badge, police ID number on it. Number one. Number two, they will have a name tag. A name tag on it. That's number two. They will have a police badge with their police ID. And number two, they will have a name badge. Okay? And number three, you will have to check their behavior. You have to check their activities to make sure that they are doing the job of a police officer. Is this the normal job that a regular police officer does? And is that police officer also with another group of police officers? Then yes, that is a police officer. But if you see a group of security detail and these group of security detail are not doing the same behavior as a regular security detail, as well as if these security details do not have any kind of name badge on them, as well as if these security details do not have a badge on them that says I'm a peace officer, or a badge that says I have a license to perform security services. I have a license, I have taken a class, or I have a number, or I have some kind of badge on me that says I have the license to perform security services. Then these security details are not security licensed security officers. Okay? You have to understand the difference, okay? They are private security contractors versus a licensed security contractors, okay? There is a difference, okay? Especially at these rallies where there is no police, local police enforcement present. And that's what I went through at the DNC. I did not see any, I all saw was security detail sitting in a box. And the only thing that the security detail responded to They had an incident, and as soon as they got out of the box, they ran out of the box in groups of four. That is not security detail. That is not how security works, as well as with local department officials. If you are a licensed health professional, you have to let the, and you going, are you going to a major, major rally in another city? You have to figure out some way to be connected to other health administrators, other health officials in that city. You cannot just show up to that city and perform a service in that city without local hospitals and local clinics knowing that they also need to send out services to that city. Okay? To their own city. If you are a nurse, a doctor, a clinician, even a CNA, and you are being shipped out to different cities to perform services, you have to figure out some way to be connected with the local hospitals and the local clinics in that city. Okay, if you are working at a temporary agency, you have to figure out, make sure that that temporary agency has you connected some way with somebody local in that city. You cannot just perform services all of a sudden blindsided in a city with nobody around and you are the only person performing services in that city. That's not how the medical field works. We are all connected together. It's a medical community. We are all connected together. We are all connected together in the medical field, okay? As well as if you go to that convention, if you go to that event and they say, oh, I'm sorry, well, we have 10,000 people at this event. We don't need your services. We have our own services. We have our own security. We have our own medical people. It's fine. I understand you have your own people. I understand, but I'm still here. And I will still provide services. What you do if you go to an event and they say, and you do not see any kind of medical people at this event, okay, it's a national event, it's a protest, and they say, we do not need your services, what you do is you go up, you let the administrators, you let the supervisors at this event know, you show them your credentials, you show them your services, you say, okay, I will still be at this event, I will still be able to provide services. You go to that event, you make a little, do a little touch and talk, then you go to the local hospitals, local areas around the city, and you let the local medical administrators know in that city that there is a major, major, big event in this city. You guys need to know about it. How come you guys are not there at this event in the city, which is what I did in Milwaukee? You need to send somebody to this event. Send somebody to this city. Send somebody to this site. And on top of that, one of the major hospitals in Milwaukee was Advocate Aurora, St. Paul. I was a former employee at Advocate Aurora. Okay? And on top of that, the Advocate Hospital was a half a mile, 15-minute walk from the DNC Convention Center in Milwaukee. Okay, but there was no Advocate van, there was no Advocate setup, there was no Advocate outside clinic, nowhere in the facility of a major, major, major nationwide event. Okay? There was no Advocate hospital, no Advocate hospital rep. At that site for the DNC in Milwaukee, as well as in Vermont, as well as in California, wherever these political officials were, there was no major, major hospital official at this site, at this nationwide site, convention center, whether it was another party was in Vermont, whether another party was in California, they still needed somebody to be present at this event. Somebody, whether it's a nurse or a COVID tester, coming through the hotel doors at this event. What you do is you make a touch and go. You greet them, you say hi, bye, and then you go get help. Especially if it's under your creative ethics. It is under your creed, your personal creed of ethics. You are in the medical field. You are actually supposed to be able to have a creed. I will protect and I will be responsible for the health and welfare of the community. It's under the creed of ethics. Okay. Now, you go to the local hospitals in that vicinity. If there are no hospitals in the vicinity, then you go to a pharmacy, a local pharmacy, a CVS or Walgreens. If there are no CVS or Walgreens in that vicinity, then what do you do? What do you do? You go to the police. Especially right now, dealing with COVID-19 research. The police need to know that there is a major, whether the police have been let off that assignment or not, they still need to know that there is a major event down the street in their city, as well as the local Department of Health, as well as the Department of Mental Health, as well as the Department of Public Safety. Whoever you can connect with at these hospital facilities, you need to let them know that there is an event going on. I need you guys to send somebody out there. I need to get some kind of help. Okay? Come on. Hello. Okay? You need to let people know that there is a come on. You need to let people know. Are you okay? Are you sure? Okay. You need to let people know there is an event going on and this event needs some help. Okay, there's no shame, there's nothing to hide. There is nothing to hide, okay? It is the truth, okay? All right, so again, this is the Queen Bottle First Aid Responder Services. This is what I do. I love being involved here. My next license is to get my community health license here from the Massachusetts Department of Health, as well as I'm getting my licensing for peer support services, okay? I'm trying to get licensed as a community health advocate as well as a peer support specialist here at the Massachusetts Department of Health. It's not the Boston, it's not the City of Boston Department of Health. This is one of the state Department of Health facilities, okay? Where you can actually get licensed as, check your licensing with the Board of Health. It's also the Board of Health here. This is one of their smaller offices, the Board of Health here. As well as a local, this is the Board of Nurses right here, as well as local community services and local community agencies provide assistance and provide services here in this building. Speak for that. 239 Medford Street, Boston, Massachusetts. Check it out. Coming live from Boston, Massachusetts, this is the Queen Bottle First Aid Responder Services. I will be in Charlotte, North Carolina. Check it, doing outside medical first aid services at the Charlotte RNC. I just came back from the DNC in Milwaukee. It was great. I got kicked out. I said, you know, whatever. It is great. It is what it is here. Okay, it is what it is. Okay, I will be in Charlotte, North Carolina on Monday, doing emergency first aid services, as well as I will be in D.C. Friday, August 28th at the National Mark on Washington. I will be in Washington, D.C. Okay, guys? COVID is not over. COVID is not over. It has just begun. COVID has just begun, okay? COVID has just begun. We still have a lot more to do, okay? We still have a lot more. Get involved and to provide. Come on, babes. You know, to provide services for those who are in need. Okay, all right. This is Queen Bottle Certified National Certified Medical Assistant, Certified Adult and Pediatric First Aid, Certified CPR, Graduate of Honors from Purdue University, Graduate of Honors from Harry Washington College, Graduate of Honors from Northwest Educational Institute. Now pursuing. All right, RN pursuing medical school pretty soon here at the Massachusetts Department of Health. This guy is the going to the building at his 5 o'clock. Oh my God. Pursuing medical soon in about medical school in about 2 years. Okay. Today here on Friday, there's a lot more to do. A lot more to do. have more resources available here in the city of Boston, with over 100 clinics and over 100 hospitals. Just top 10 hospitals all of the United States are here in the city of Boston. So I'm glad to be here. Again, LaQueen Battle from Battle First Aid Responder Services here in the city of Boston, in the State Department of Health, one of the great facilities for life services. Glad to meet with you guys here. I will see you Monday in Charlotte for the RNC providing emergency outside first aid services, as well as your community health activism and contracting with local law and hospital enforcement agencies. Okay, guys, touch back with me here at the Massachusetts Department of Health Licensing Bureau. Okay, this is LaQueen. Love you guys.